Introducing on table number one from Cleveland, the England number four, Karina Le Fevre. She will play against the current title holder, the number two seed, and the England number two, Kelly Sibley. And our umpire and assistant is Alan White and Derek Sherritt. Meanwhile, table number three, we have a matchup here between the England number one senior against the England number one junior. Introducing them, first of all, he's the current title holder, he's the England number one, he's also from Cleveland, it's Paul Tinko. And he'll be playing against, as I said, the England number one junior, currently underrated due to inactivity at 24 on the men's. I'm sure he'll rise from that. It's Sam Walker, Nottinghamshire. And our umpire and assistant is Mick Strode and Derek Sidaway. Let the matches commence.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to this women's singles semi-final between the number two seed and defending champion Kelly Sibley, and at this side, the number four seed Karina Le Fevre from Cleveland.
Peter.
Karina there with a great forehand flick over the table on the Kelly Sibley serve. Out wide to the Kelly forehand, showing her intent early on. Just clipping the net there from Kelly Sibley. She tried to hold the table and dominate with score level in this first game, 3-3. Both players still trying to find some rhythm in this first opening set. But the score's a level 6-6. Backhand over the table from Karina, forcing down the forehand side of Kelly. Karina with a fortunate net cord there with an opening backhand shot. Kelly unable to notice what difference on the ball. So scores level 9-9 first set. It's Kelly with the first set point from the enforced area of Karina. Karina really getting her forehand in close over the table into the Sibley backhand to bring the scores level 10-10. Great spin there from Sibley. The ball was pushed deep into her hip, but she's managed to create lots of topspin on that forehand. And Karina just overhitting that next shot.
Game 12-10, Sibley.
And Kelly Sibley wins the first set, 12-10. Let's take a one set love to love lead.
second game.
So it's Kelly Sibley, the defending double champion, to start the second set.
Number one.
Great forehands there by Kelly Sibley. The serve set up nicely, the ball just popping up, and she was able to take the forehand down the forehand side to win the point. 1-1.
On two.
Great rally there. Karina forced Kelly away from the table, but she wasn't able to capitalise with the unforced error in the net.
3-7.
Just clipping the net there, trying to be positive. But Kelly with a controllable lead in the second set, 9-3. Kelly, great demonstration there of exchanging different the spins. And then following up with a heavy forehand topspin to the forehand to create 7 set points in this second set. And she takes the set with some excellent backhands over the table. Followed up nicely to win the second set, 11-3, and take a comfortable lead, 2-0. So just to bring you up to date who these people beat in the quarterfinals, Karina Le Fevre beat Tressa Armitage 4-2, whilst Kelly Sibley beat Tintin Ho also 4-2. Kelly starting off where she left off, with great backhands over the table, following up with an excellent one there down the forehand side.
we go.
Great power there displayed by Sibley. Getting in forehand strong down the forehand side, creating an early lead in this third game.
Love four.
Great display by Sibley there. Forehand down the backhand, forehand down the forehand side for the winner. Really good play. Open up a strong lead in this third game. 6-6.
Two
great slow spins there by Kelly Sibley. Great footwork demonstrated also. Forced in the area and taking control in this third set of this women's singles semi-final. Rally, both players exchanging some strong shots. It was Kelly's power what just dominated that rally towards the end. Kelly Sibley winning the third set 11-4, taking a 3-6 lead in this semi-final.
Fourth game, Sibley to serve, level. Level. Serve one. One all.
Good positive start by Karina in this fourth set, playing some strong shots away from the table, but Kelly just working an opening to bring the scores level at one set, 1 point all in this fourth set. Good strong play demonstrated there by Karina, really pinning Kelly down the backhand side, forcing the error. Again, great play, back and flick over the table, followed with a strong forehand into the hip of Kelly Sibley.
2-3.
Well read there by Kelly Sibley, the forehand, the backhand just clipping the net from Karina, but Kelly was able to adjust and play a strong forehand topspin down the backhand side. Great rally there by both players. Karina taking the initiative over the table, forcing Kelly back away into defensive shots. Taking the lead 6-4.
Seven, four.
Just clipping the net there and just missing the table, but it was good aggressive play, just what Karina needs to do in the semi-final to get back in it. But she still holds a slight lead, 7-5 in this game. Great play by Kelly there. Good heavy spin on the third ball and followed it up well with moving the ball with the fifth shot. And the backhand going along from Karina, but at least she's still being positive and wanting to still play her shots. Important service to come. Great rally there, both players showing their strengths. Karina smashing the ball over the table. Kelly demonstrating good defence, but that time Karina with the better power in the end. And another excellent rally there. Backhands and forehands all over the table, both demonstrating great footwork. It's Karina what gives two set points. The opening topspin there by Kelly, just catching the net. Bring her back into this, reduce the deficit of this set to just one.
Hello.
The opportunity was there by Karina, but just snatched it at the crucial time. Kelly reduces the deficit, and now it's at 10-all in this fourth set.
No! 10-11.
A forced error there by Karina. Kelly opens up the first match point. Great forehand topspin there by Karina, playing ever so well. First one was good, and the second one even better, finding the white line at a crucial stage of the match.
Game 14-12, the first.
Karina takes that fourth set, 14-12, reduces the deficit to 3-1 in this women's singles semi-final.
Thank you. game. The third to serve, Lowell. One out. Love two.
You can see the frustration just creeping into Sibley game. But Karina up in the game just when she needed it. Reduced a 3-0 lead.
3-1.
Great aggressive forehand play there from Kelly Sibley. Followed up with the first one with excellent next two. Again, moving the forehand well there. First one into the body, second one out to the forehand side. Bring the scores level, 4-4. Great rally there, both players demonstrating great footwork and great technique. And Karina seeing the opportunity to hit the backhand winner down the forehand side, and she did so with excellent control.
Thank you.
interesting debate here, wondering whether the forehand of Karina Le Fevre touched the edge of the table, whether it was side. I'm going to sit on the fence, I think. See this frustration coming into Kelly Sibley's game at a crucial time. Set point, Karina Le Fevre. Karina takes it on the first opportunity. 3-0 down, she's demonstrated an excellent comeback. Reduces the deficit to 3-2. On the men's game, Paul Drinkle is currently 3-2 ahead in games, and 4-0 in this sixth set. A great exchange of backhands between both players there. Karina gaining the slight advantage with the point to bring the scores level 1-1 in this sixth set. A great backhand topspin there by Kelly Sibley, seeing the opportunity early, finding the white line, great shot. Likewise, great play by Karina. Strong backhand into the forehand, followed up with a great forehand into the forehand side also to win the point, bring the scores level. Karina just being slightly frustrated with herself there. Saw it as an opportunity, but just snatched at the ball, catching the net. Kelly with a slight lead in the sixth game. Great defense by Kelly, forced away from the table, but kept the spin on the ball to gain an advantage in this sixth set, 4-2. Great play by Karina, getting it strong early over the table with the forehand flick and the backhand, finding the outer side of the backhand corner of the Sibley table. Scores level 4-4.
Point 4.
Five all. Five, six.
Good positive rally by both players, and Karina just catching the net. Back in the game now at 6-6 in this sixth set. Great play by Karina over the table, seeing the topspin of Kelly, but was able to play a strong backhand to it to bring the scores level in this sixth game, 7-7. Good play by Karina, kept the ball down the backhand side. Kept it going, one shot after the next, and forcing the error from Kelly. Took a slight lead in this sixth game. Great play by Kelly Sibley, working her opponent away from the table, and then was able to play a strong backhand down the backhand side. Strong play by Karina with the backhand early, creating a set point. Great rally there by both players. Karina holding the table well, forcing Kelly back away from the table. And she takes it on the first opportunity. Great comeback from 3-0 down to bring the scores level 3-3 in this semi-final. So just to confirm, the men's singles first semi-final, it was a win for Paul Drinkall. 4-2 over a valiant effort by Sam Walker in his first appearance in the semi-final of the men's singles. But Karina to start this final set in the women's singles semi-final. Karina with a pong strong positive start, taking an early advantage 3-2-0 in this final set. Good serve, that was a bit more topspin on that serve, forcing the error early to reduce the deficit in this final set. Crucial time coming up. What a rally from both players. The ball moving all over the court. Both trying to stay strong, close to the table, and it was Kelly Sibley that won the point to bring the scores level 2-0, 2-0. Great play by Karina, holding the table with the backhand side. Forced an opportunity. When she did, she went straight down the forehand side of Sibley. By Kelly, mixing the play. Backhand when she did, straight down the forehand side. Bring the scores level 3-3. Karina holding the table well, forcing the error from Kelly.
Come on!
5-3-10.
Karina acknowledging her good fortune, but it was still strong play over the table, forcing Kelly back. As the change ends, Karina holds an advantage, 5-3 in this final set. Good angle there by Karina. The serve drifted long. Kelly was able to top spin, but she was able to follow it up with a good counter down the line. So it's Kelly Sibley who calls the first time out in this semi-final, trailing 6-3.
Service.
Good strong play by Sibley there, running around getting the forehand in early and seizing the opportunity with the backhand.
Eight, four.
The serve drifting long. Karina saw it early, great spin to open up a 4-point lead in this final set with two serves to come. Demonstrating what she'll be doing in this comeback, holding the table well and moving the ball around. Good service by Sibley, reducing the deficit to three, with one more serve to come.
Nine,
again, another strong service. Karina acknowledging that she just lost 2 points in quick succession, so she's just taking some time with a timeout. Both players come back to the table in this final set. It's Karina Le Fevre to serve with a 2-point advantage, 9-7. Strong comeback, 3 points on the succession to reduce the deficit to just one in this final set. Good strong spin, the serve was drifting long and Kelly ran around and got a great forehand topspin in. And the scores are level, 9-0 in this final set. Acknowledging the fortune, hitting the net. And it creates match points in this very close match. Good strong play by Karina. Getting in early with the backhand and following it up well to bring the scores level in this decider at 10-all. Kelly with a change of direction on the return of service, going straight into the forehand to create another match point. And just hitting the net and drifting long. And again, the score's a level, 11-all. An unforced error brings Karina a match point. What a great rally. Forced back from the table, showing grit and determination to keep in this match. Bring the scores level at 12-all. Kelly with a great change of direction there, going in the forehand and catching her out, going down the forehand again to bring match point to Kelly Sibley. Kelly wins it 14-12 in the deciding set. Great effort by Karina. She was trailing 3-0 in this match. But a great effort to get back in and to force it all the way to deuce, even having a match point for herself. But in the end, it's Kelly Sibley, the defending champion, that progresses into the final, where she'll play either Joanna Parker or Emma Vickers. Coming up next on table one will be Andrew Bagley against Liam Pitchford in the men's semi-final. Coming soon.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, two very enthralling semi-final singles. Well, we're in for a real treat if the next two are going to be the same. Just a few words then from Paul Drinkle. Two title holders left in the tournament. Please come in, Paul. Congratulations on your win. But you were actually made to work quite hard there. A few new kids on the block in both the girls and the boys. Your thoughts?
Yeah, I think, you know, Sam's improved a lot this last year. But for me, it was very good as well. The difficult match, that was my first one. This one, you know, I lost a set in that one. And he did push me until the end. He's improved a lot, and I'm sure he'll be back next year.
Changing topics completely, how's the Olympic Games improved you as a player, do you think?
It's just obviously a great experience. You know, playing matches like this now, it becomes like more normal when you play in front of 4,000 or 5,000 people screaming your name and things like that. And it was amazing, and hopefully it can help me win the title today.
Terrific. Ladies and gentlemen, England number one, he's on course to retain his title. He currently has four, Paul Drinkle.